Good morning, students. Today again I am coming with the explanation of this lesson 1 crop production, the third part for class 8. So what is transplantation and why it is done? So transplantation means it is a process mainly used in the agricultural field where the seeds are firstly sown in a field which is said as a nursery. And from when these seeds, means saplings, are coming from there, then after they are again taken out from them, and then in another field they are planted in a maintained way or in a planned way field. So that process is said as the transplantation. So it is a process of making the nursery. So it is very common among this paddy. So in paddy, all of you are looking that firstly the seeds are sown in Assamese we say kothia. So prathomote kothia hise means dhan khini kisi diye tar pra kothia ulai he kothia khini ni aku main pothar khonot ruwe bhui ruwa boli jitu koy okome tumaloke jana sake. So this process firstly planted in one and then after taken out and grown in another one, so that is transplantation. It is also very common among these flowers, you know, various types of flowers we are buying from the nursery, in the flower nursery. So where these saplings of the flowers are growing, then after we are bringing them from there and we are planting in a planned way to get the proper growth of that particular flower. So this process is transplantation. So you remember this process. Then after, another method of this agricultural processes, among these agricultural practices, one important method is there, that is the adding manure and fertilizers. So first of all, you have to know what are fertilizers and what are manures. Are they same and what is their function, why they are used or why they should be used? So first of all, I want to tell you manure. So manure means those substances which are given to the cultivatory field for the better growth of the plants. So that are said as the manures. In Assamese we say har. So these manures are actually the natural substances. They are not artificial, they are not synthesized, they are natural substances, for example cow dung. Okay, so these manures, when it is given to the field, to the crop field, then what is happening, it makes the soil porous. You understand, no? Porous means it is making gaps among the soil particles. So as a result, what happened, the air and water easily can penetrate in that gaps, and they may give proper nutrition to the plant. So this is the manure and it is their function. But remember, manures do not provide much chemicals. That means those chemicals which are required for the growth of the plant, those minerals which are required for the growth of the plants. So excessive or maximum number of minerals or like chemicals are not there in the manure. So that is why you don't think that when you give the manures to the plants, so they will get the proper nutrients like that. You don't think, because proper nutrients they may not get also. But what they are getting, they will get proper air and proper water. So because manures are making the gaps in the soil particles. So that is manure. And again, I told also that manures are natural. On the other hand, fertilizers. Fertilizers are, means they are the chemicals. Actually, fertilizers are the chemicals which are containing those minerals and those chemicals which are essential for the growth and development of the plant. So that means they are synthesized artificially, they are made providing those chemicals, those nutrients which are essential for the better development of the plant. So like that, things are kept in the fertilizers and they are provided to the plant. So plant at that time, they no need to do more, means hard work for obtaining that chemicals. They will be provided to the plants and that plants easily can take it. So means like this, you know, some ready-made notes are given to you, okay, at that time you have no need to read more books or no need to search them in the net or no need to search anywhere. You are just getting that notes. I am giving you some ready-made notes. So then you are not doing any hard work for the collection of that notes. Easily you are getting from me. So that is like fertilizers. So fertilizers are those which are given to the plants. Easily plants can absorb it. Understand, no? But nutrients, manures are not like this. Manures means they are giving the environment to the plant for obtaining the nutrients. So for resembling with me, I can tell you that directly I am not giving you the answer, but I am giving you the hints of getting the answer. But answer you have to collect yourself. So that is manure. Manure is doing that work. Manure is directly not giving any nutrients to the plant. It is making the environment that the plants easily can get the nutrients. But fertilizers are directly the nutrients given to the plant. Okay, so that is fertilizers and manures. Manures are natural, already I told you, and fertilizers are synthetic. They are synthesized. Now, most of the times it is asking the difference between manures and fertilizer. That is a very, very, very common question. So first of all, I want to tell you that manures are natural, okay, and fertilizers are synthetic. That means manures are made or they can be obtained from the natural things, but fertilizers are synthesized by human beings from chemicals. Secondly, manures do not provide any nutrients directly to the plant, but fertilizers are providing some essential nutrients directly to the plant. Okay, thirdly, excessive use of manures also do not spoil the plant or do not cause any pollution to the soil. Okay, but excessive use of fertilizers, it will cause pollution. It will, instead of helping the plant to grow, if we are using excessively the fertilizers, then it will damage the plant. So that are the differences between them. You will try to write by your own. Then here differences are also given. 5 differences are given, so you will read it in page number 10. It is given and you by heart. Then advantages of using manure. Some advantages are there. First of all, it improves the texture of the soil. Already I told you that use of manures actually provides those that environment from where the plants easily can obtain their nutrients. Secondly, it makes the soil porous, already I told you. Thirdly, it enhances the water holding capacity of the soil. So as soil is made porous by the use of the manures, then the soil easily can hold the water. And when the water is holded by the soil, then from that soil, plants easily can collect the water. And through the water, the minerals are also going to the body of the plants. That I think you understand. And then fourthly, it increases the number of soil friendly microbes. So that is another important thing. So when this soil is become porous, when the soil is made available for the air and water, definitely the microorganisms will come there, because microorganisms are living in the water and air as well as in the soil. So when they are getting chance, when they are getting the space, definitely they will come. So among them, some microorganisms are very friendly to the plants. For example, rhizobium. Just one example I am giving. So that type of microorganisms will develop there, and they will help in the growth and development of the plants. So as a means a conclusion, I would like to tell you that manure, directly it is not helping the plant, but indirectly it is helping the plant. It is giving the full environment, full means facilities, but plants have to take by their own. But fertilizers, they are ready-made. That means they are given to the plants directly the nutrients. They are not creating any environment friendly atmosphere around the plant, but they are directly giving the nutrients to the plant. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the use of manures and fertilizers. So that is for today. I hope you understood. And till my next video, you take care. Try to answer these questions given in a back, and let me know any doubt if it is there. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.